Ron.
Hi.
Great to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Okay, so you're from Tuned. Tell me what Tuned is and tell our YouTube audience.
Okay, so first, thank you very much for stopping by our booth. Tuned is an AI-powered FDA-cleared platform for self-fitting of hearing aids. Basically, we provide the software solution for hearing aid manufacturers and brand, so to go to the market with an FDA-cleared, best-in-class fitting software. We also do, of course, the entire onboarding, which means hearing diagnostics, first fit of the hearing aids, and any related after-sales service. So we, one of our patent technology is our AI audiologist, as we like to call it. Basically, it's a chatbot that was trained by a group of audiologists, myself included,
okay,
and can understand different kind of issues, troubleshooting, or questions that users might have, and can actually answer them, educate them, and have full control over the device parameters so they can fine-tune the device for them, exactly as a human audiologist would have done.
So you're telling me that with the software that you guys build that will go into OTC hearing aids, this helps with the, I guess, with the removal of audiologists from the equation, thinking of everything to make sure it's as comprehensive as possible.
So we're not trying to get the audiologists out of the equation. We want to give a 24/7 support tool for hearing aid users, especially in the first few weeks of use, which is the crucial window to getting used to hearing aids. We know the return rates are very high currently in the OTC market, and we think the main reason is that you don't have that after-service support with the OTC solution that you buy. We do think that audiologist is a crucial point in that hearing health awareness and helping people hear better, but we think that 80-90% of the problems could be solved with our AI audiologist, and we think this should be the first a line of solution that users interact with before is approaching an audiologist.
I think that's a very important point that you make, because my big concern over the years since the birth of OTC hearing aids in 2022 was, I as an audiologist and you as an audiologist too, know and understand the importance of audiologists within this equation. So it's a case of how we can essentially have the tech in place to ensure that nothing is missing from an OTC point of view. And again, you hit the nail on the head by saying that there is an incredibly high return rate of OTC hearing aids. I guess some of the cool things that have happened recently with OTC hearing aids we've seen some big names involved. So we've had Sony involved, who've been around for a while now. We've had Bose involved, but then Apple recently got involved, didn't they? And what impact do you think that'll have on the market?
So I think Apple is a major milestone in the hearing health industry. So if we just look at the stats, so Apple's ad for hearing aid functionality in their AirPods during Christmas time reached 51 million people in just a month.
51 million people.
Yeah, so if we talk about the big five companies doing their own ads, they never reach combined that number. And I think that will have a ripple effect to the entire industry. So people are getting aware of hearing health, how there are other solutions out there. And I think that's a stepping stone for them to introduce to OTC solution. And after that, maybe prescription hearing aids.
I think this is really interesting, because I have to say that, and I feel a bit sorry for the traditional hearing aid manufacturers, because they've always been terrible B2C marketing. B2B they've got to, because they have to go through the audiologists. And so they've never really, if you were to say Phonak, Widex, Resound, Signia, Stargy, etc., to a random person on the street, they would have no idea who you were talking about. But of course you say Apple, and now you say Apple AirPod Pro 2 hearing aids, and this is what's going to cause the balloon in terms of the industry.
Definitely.
It's really exciting. And so you were telling me earlier that you are involved in the software side of things.
Right.
Is your tech already involved in certain hardware? Are there certain manufacturers that are already using your software?
Yeah, so a great question. So we are currently integrated into three different manufacturers. Okay. We started working with Intracon, where we first introduced our first commercial product, which was the JVC branded hearing aids. Those are available already on the market. Very good satisfaction rate, lowest return rate in the industry according to JVC press release, 13.5 return rate, which is far below the average of the market. We also now introducing the second generation for JVC hearing aids, which are based on the Novidan devices, which are great manufactured here in the US and in the Minnesota.
Are they available yet? Or?
They are about to be available. Okay. We are finishing everything. It's already working here in the booth, and we are introducing that commercially in the next few weeks. And the third manufacturer is Jigao, which is a leading Chinese manufacturer. They will also be introducing their, I think, lower cost OTC solution in the market. branded under a US brand here in the US. That will also be coming up in the next week. And we are also working with two other manufacturers. One of them is the Japanese, and the other one is another Asian manufacturer to introduce our solution also in the Asian market.
And what's unique about your software versus the software that's built into anybody else's OTC hearing aids?
So we took a different approach on this entire hearing rehabilitation journey. So first of all, we understood that OTC main problem will be that you took the audiologist out of the equation. There is a vacuum there. You have to fill that vacuum in. Other companies are not addressing that problem, and I think that's the main reason they have 40% return rates.
Yeah.
So we took a more holistic approach on that. So first of all, we created what I think the best in class onboarding. It's a very easy to follow. We have 93% success rate. Average age of our users is 76. Oldest is 100 years old, lady from New York. So we create something which is very intuitive and easy to follow. But after that first fit, this is where other companies stop. And this is where actually we kicks in with our hearing rehabilitation. So we introduce a daily goal, a daily lesson. We keep our users educated with a bit size information daily that they get.
Really?
And with auditory training games that are fun and intuitive, helps the brain adapt to the hearing aids and create that stickiness of the app, which really helps the users acknowledge that they are now a hearing aid users. It takes time until they get used to it, but eventually they will enjoy the overall outcome of their hearing aids.
So two other questions just based on that. Though. Number one is, does your software always involve doing a hearing test using the app as well?
Yeah, always. Yeah, so start with the agnostics.
If I'm 100% honest with you, there's a ton of OTC hearing aids out there and they don't involve doing a hearing test. And I just don't get it. And they might have different audiological profiles, which I guess works, and it works to an extent. But for me as an audiologist, it just doesn't seem right.
It's not a hearing aid.
Have people guessing, because no one likes hearing aids to start off with. Everyone reports that they said loud, tinny, sharp, boomy, echoey. And so at least if you've got the input levels correct for that individual person, you've got that baseline to begin with. So I think that's super important as well. The second thing you just mentioned is the gamification side of things. So you mentioned about the daily updates, the daily information.
Yeah.
What kind of things will they be?
So basically I can show you in the app itself, but we have, let's go out of there. So you have a daily lesson which educates the users about hearing loss, about the hearing aids that they are using, and about the app. So some of the lessons, by the way, you will see are locked for previous sessions. So we don't want to overwhelm our users with all the information
good.
Once. But we found out that as much education you give to the users, the better satisfaction that you get out of them back. So they feel that they are part of this process, and they are get the confidence that what they are doing is right.
Yeah.
The second thing is our auditory training games. So the auditory training games idea is that how you can train the auditory brain to...
This looks amazing. Sorry to tell you. This looks brilliant.
Thank you. So let's go, for example, Transit Board is my favorite game because it mimics an everyday scenario. So let's go with the normal level, which is a different sound to noise ratio. That's the difference. And you can see I'm in an Apple terminal, and there is the guy in the background shouting where the next flight leaves from, the gate, etc. So this works also on understanding speech in background noise, in different background noise, and also short-term memory, which is extremely important for the elderly. And then users, of course, guess the right answers. You see, and I get points. And that points are being locked, and I improved over time with my hearing journey progress.
So there's an auditory training process involved as well then?
Exactly.
Really?
So that's the idea. So this is how you bring in a little bit of fun to that hearing rehabilitation journey. And again, encourage the users to go back to the app on a daily basis to interact with the games or the lessons that they get.
And from your research in terms of this app that's involved in the techness out there already, do people do it? Do people actually
45% of our users.
That's a high number.
That's higher than what we thought. We thought it would be around the 20%. 45% of our users play a game on a weekly basis.
Very cool.
So that's awesome.
I guess one more question. In terms of your goal for being at CES this year, what is it? Why are you here? Who are you reaching out to? What's your main thing that you want to achieve over the next 4 days?
So it depends about, I divide the answer to two. We want to work with as many manufacturers as possible.
Yeah.
So we think that they should focus on what they do best is creating the best hardware. And we want to provide the best software that we think is that will be the most easy for the users to engage with and will get them the best clinical outcome possible.
Yeah.
That's something that everyone in the industry wants, the best clinical outcome for their patient. We think that our software does that. Other people around here are coming from different kind of aspects in the market. Some of them are from elderly homes, some of them are a PR agency, advocating for creating awareness for hearing loss and hearing rehabilitation. And we want to show them that there are good solutions out there. And there, we know there is, it's the wild, wild west now in the hearing aids. You Google hearing aids and Amazon, you get thousands of results from Sony and Sennheiser up to a no names, $79 hearing aids. All are titled hearing aids. We want to show them that there are good solutions out there. And the reputation that I think the current reputation for OTC market is not as good. We want to try and improve that by showing that there are really good solutions out there. They don't cost as much, and you should give them a try.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for your time
today. Thank you very much.